Yulia Wulandari. Okay, let's start this presentation. The first slide will be presented by me. Okay, the first slide is definition quantitative descriptive. Quantitative descriptive research is a non-experimental type of research whereby the variables are measured using numerical terms, although the variables under interrogation are not manipulated by the researcher. Quantitative descriptive research uses two methodologies of design, namely observational research and survey research methodologies. Next is methodologies quantitative descriptive. The first is observational research. Observational research is quantitative descriptive research whereby data collection is due through observation. For example, if the researchers want to measure corruption in a country, then he or she can design a method of using fully numbers such that any time where is the case of corruption. Then this is recorded in a tally sheet, harder for the researcher to know how a country is corrupt. He or she will then compare the tally numbers in a certain period with the set benchmark tally score which has already been predetermined of how given. The next is survey research. Survey research is another type of quantitative descriptive research with advocates use of surveys of questionnaires to collect data pertaining to the behavior of subject matter. Here, until distributing of surveys of questionnaires to a big sample or the whole population is manageable so as to collect data. Besides, the purpose of this survey research is to describe physical characteristics of the population. It is much in order to resemble this selection using a probability sampling technique to ensure more accurate representation of the sample to the population. Thanks. Okay, next is types of quantitative descriptive. The first is descriptive survey research. It is a research design which is set to collect data for the simple purpose of describing the character of the subject matter. It is one point inside of the process of collecting data. And the second is cross-sectional survey research. Research design or study which involves the investigation of features of different samples of population whereby they are taken at one point in time. And the last one is longitudinal survey research. It is a research design or study which involves the investigation of the characteristic of respondent whereby the measurements are taken at different points in time. Okay, then the next slide will be presented by Azhra Mino.
Type of data,
to be collected and how it will be collected and analyzed. Data presentation and classification thereof and number three of the investigation.
There is no manipulation of the variables for this species of observed in non-experimental in nature. And the five, data is collected either at one data point of or several data points. Six, it is descriptive in nature, this research only, and eight, describing or giving a narration of the character of the subject matter and does not show any relationship or causality. And the second, foundational, this research is the basis of other high-end research for it aligns the basis of the number of the variable that exists. It has given a hint of whether the variable of course other variables could change. This then becomes the basis for future research. And the eighth, generalizability in researching things are always generalized. That is, the research will be broadened from the sample each user to generalize about the characteristic of the whole population. The next material, definition of qualitative description. What is a qualitative descriptive research? It is a widely treated research tradition and has been identified as important and appropriate for research questions focused on discovering the who, what, and where of event or experience and gaining insight from informants regarding a poorly understood phenomenon. It is also the level of choice when a straight description of phenomenon is designed or information is to be put and defined questionnaire or interpretation. Qualitative descriptive measure aims to obtain a complete picture of a matter according to a particular context. It's not that well. Types of qualitative descriptive. Equation is subject into experience. Biography is research about the person and his personal experience that are found to the research directly or through secondary sources such as document or archives. And then third, ethnographic research. Ethnographic research is the most independent observational method that studies people in their personal naturally according to environment. And the fourth, case study research. This case study method has evolved over the past few years and put into a few valuable research method. As the name suggests, it is used for explaining an organization or an entity. And the last, graded theory is a methodological analysis of research data and is used to evaluate interviews, observation, protocols, participation, direct involvement, and so on. It is a system of rules for evaluating qualitative data with the aim of methodology controlling this process and training, making it understandable and variable. Okay, the next material will be the print my friend time to start.
Quantitative research method and the interpret as research method based on
research is an umbrella term referring to several research traditions and strategies that serve to find commonalities. There is an emphasis on process or how things happen and a focus on attitude, belief, and so how people make sense of their experience as they interpret their world. Qualitative descriptive research emphasizes inductive reasoning, whereby the researcher seeks to develop hypotheses from observation. Okay, that's all of our presentation about descriptive, qualitative, and quantitative. Do you have any question? Please ask to us.
Okay, I have any question for group H. What are the advantages of using descriptive reasoning?
Okay, I will ask the question. Jana's question. Advantage of using descriptive research. Advantage of descriptive research. Able to analyze difficult topic by numerical measurements.